to see me, Captain?
Yes, I've got a letter for you, Tom. It's postmarked Washington, D.C.
Well, this is it. They want me to report to Seattle on Saturday. Ensign Adams. Admiral in 6 months.
Hey, Admiral, you ain't in the Navy yet. And I ain't going to accept your resignation until you pilot in the Lock Haven tomorrow.
Money for a while.
As a matter of fact, you're going to have to frame that commission in burlap.
What other spot in the world?
Hey, by the way, would you marry me?
Well, it's about time you asked me. When?
Monday, July 2nd, Seattle. 5 minutes after I'm sworn into the Navy. I guess you are.
Well, you're doing all right, too.
I'm doing fine.
They're loaded in there, Tom.
Maybe the Lock Haven will be early, too. For once in their life.
Say, the Coast Guard patrol is going out to the point about the time the Lock Haven is due. You could go out on her and say Betsy's the trouble.
No, thanks. Betsy'd never forgive me if we didn't pilot in our last ship together.
Direction. Uncle Sam.
Come aboard, please. All three of you.
I was bringing them in.
Is that why you turned around when you sighted us and ran for it, Mr. Adams?
They forced me to turn around. This one had a gun on my back.
Really, Mr. Adams? No good to lie.
I tell you, I'm not lying. I got it away from him, knocked it overboard.
You managed it very badly, Mr. Adams. Now we are caught.
They're sure because I was bringing them in. They're framing me.
But you were more than 4 miles beyond your regular station.
Listen, Lieutenant. I was waiting for the lockhead. I decided to run out and take a look for it. I spotted these two being put overboard from a freighter. I never even expected to see it out there.
I saw no freighter.
You were inventing badly, Mr. Adams.
I'm afraid I'll have to put you under arrest.
Listen, Lieutenant.
There's nothing else I can do.
Why would I want to smuggle in a couple of chaps?
That's for the court to decide.
All arrangements previously made. Pilot Bud was paid $250 to meet us.
We picked up the defendant at a point 4 miles beyond the regular pilot station. As soon as he sighted us, he turned and headed away from us.
Lockhaven didn't show up. I spotted the suspicious-looking freighter out there and headed for it.
What was the name of the ship?
SS Hanseatic, London, England.
SS Hanseatic, London, England. Officially listed by the British Admiralty as sunk in Australian waters on November 10th, 1940.
The jury reached a verdict?
Yes, Your Honor. The jury finds the defendant guilty.
Therefore, the court does sentence you to 5 years in the federal prison at Blackport.
Okay, kid, it's the screw in that pillbox up there. Tell the little man who you're looking for.
I'd like...
And don't strain your tonsils. The joint's wired for sound.
Oh. I'd like to see Mr. Thomas Adams, please. I'm Nancy Johnson.
Johnson to see Adams.
LaRue to see LaRue.
LaRue to see LaRue.
That's me, Billie LaRue.
Oh, what's his rap?
What?
How long is he in for? What was he doping up to get caught doing? And don't tell me he's innocent.
Well, as a matter of fact, he is.
Isn't that a coincidence? 3,000 of them in here, every one of them innocent. Hey, good luck. Look where you go.
Oh, Citizen, His Excellency, Senator Malloy.
Hey, there's a chance for you, sister.
He's head of the parole board. Why don't you tell him your little story? He only hears it 3,000 times a day.
Thanks. Maybe I will. Gate. Take a load off your feet, because what I'm going to say to you will cut you right down to my size.
Talk some more, baby. I like to hear you talk.
Well, you won't like what you're going to hear, because I'm through, Monk. I'm washed up.
Oh, sure, baby, sure.
Didn't you hear what I said, you big gorilla? I'm scrambling out of here. I'm fed up. I'm telling you goodbye. I'm going back to burlesque. The next bump I take's going to be for dough.
Some guy bothering you.
No. Don't you understand? I'm quitting.
Oh, sure, baby, sure.
Nobody sentenced me to 10 years of hard labor. Working my hands off him for what? An orangutan who can't use his big hands like a gentleman.
Talk some more, baby. Go ahead.
I give up. They can't make him that dumb. So long, you big chimp. I'll be seeing you in 1948.
Billy. Let me hear you talk some more, baby.
Okay, gargantua. You win. Just another sucker, that's me.
Sure, baby.
I suppose I should ask. Do you get enough food? Are they treating you right? These people usually ask.
Skip it, Nancy.
It's good to see you.
Even like this? That's a lie. You shouldn't have come, Nancy.
I'm going to get you out of here, Tom.
And there's no use kidding ourselves. I'm in for 5 years there. There's nothing more we can do about it.
We can get a new trial, Tom. We can fight. Remember me when I get mad?
At a kid. Sick him.
I will, too, plenty. I'm getting a lawyer, Tom. Somebody who can reach the right people.
I had a lawyer, didn't I? You better forget about me and all the pipe dreams we had together.
You can't forget a thing that was going to be your whole life.
You got to.
No use, Tom, no matter how long it is.
Nancy, go back home.
No use, Tom.
You do as I tell you.
Madam, if you place your husband's case in my hands, I assure
you. Why did you see Mallory, huh? You know what I heard about you? I heard you couldn't even fix a traffic ticket.
Michael Mallory, madam, attorney at law at your service.
Not Senator Mallory?
No, madam, merely Judge Mallory. The senator is my beloved brother. Perhaps I could help you.
Could you arrange an appointment for me to see your brother? If I could just
Fast, young lady, not so fast. I couldn't bother my brother with a case until I knew all the facts. I suggest you come and see me at my office tomorrow morning. You're staying here in town, aren't you?
Yes, I'm staying. I'll do anything that'll help.
My dear, you are making a wise and courageous decision. Until tomorrow, then.
Innocent in person.
Come on in.
Back up the band, Dora. Play that schmaltzer part again about loving them so.
Miss Innocent all up. That
you seem to be everywhere, Miss Blue.
Well, discouraged you, Annie. I happen to live here.
On the contrary. The place takes on added charm.
That's putting the zipper on you, big mouth. Meet your new cellmate. This is Winnie. And that's dumb Dora back there. The bird goes by the name of Lifer. Girls, this is Little Miss Innocent. Alias Nancy Johnson.
Well, I thought maybe you had a message from the prison. I've had the strangest feeling about George all day. What's your man in for? George got a long stretch for fraud, but he'll be out soon.
Slam the door like that every time.
I'll get a load of this. It's Scarlett O'Hara.
Why, Billy, honey, you flatter me.
You bet your life I do. Oh, this is Nancy, a new fish. And this animal act goes by the name of Gwen.
Hello.
Hello. Oh, look at these hands. I used to have beautiful hands. Imagine a lady of my type spending my youth in a laundry for $18 a week.
Imagine a lady of your type being a lady.
I've had about enough out of you. One more crack like that and
that is, Scarlett. Your southern accent slipping.
She's jealous, honey, because I spent last winter with my husband, Chess, at Miami Beach. We stayed at the best hotels in New York and all over.
Where's Chess to stop him now, sugar?
Irregardless, he's a very wealthy man. He's got $60,000.
Half of it's mine. Well, I hear it. That $60,000 belongs to National Bank and Trust Company.
You all be sorry someday when Chester tells me where the money's hidden. You all be sorry.
So will Chester. Maybe I'd better come back later. Stick around, kid. All the animals in this zoo are harmless.
Miss Barton will be here at 6. She's always here by then.
Just like a clock. Every day at 6.
Go up to her. As soon as she sees Joseph, her husband. Don't be frightened. Everything will be all right. I've been here for 7 years waiting for George.
7 years?
Yes. So you see, I know all the ropes. I can help you. I want us to be friends.
Thank you, Winnie.
They keep George in solitary. They won't even let me see him. You ought to get your man out right away.
But how?
None of the others will listen to me. But you're different. You listen to me. I've got a plan. It's all worked out.
Really?
Oh, this is Nancy Johnson. She wants a room.
You better get ready for supper. This way, Nancy.
This room is $9 a week with board. But I have another room. It's a little better next to mine. Slade's room. He's leaving us in the morning. He'll have this room for $10.
But that's a dollar more. This room is smaller than the other one.
Yes, I know. But it has one great advantage.
I'd rather not see that all the time.
Mrs. Slade doesn't agree with you. She says it brings her son closer somehow, just being able to see those walls.
I'd rather take the other room.
Very well. That's the signal for supper. The first signal. When it blows again, the men will sit down to eat. And so we eat.
We don't have to eat when they do.
No. But you'll find you want to. I was showing Miss Johnson your room, Miss Slade.
Put it down, darling. Call me Mom. I've done that since he was 12.
Come and have some supper.
I'd better finish packing first.
Then let me help you.
No. No, thanks.
How long is your man in for?
5 years. But it won't be that long. Maybe not even a year.
I hope you're right. But don't count on it too much. Every girl that comes here thinks the same thing at first. After that, she either quits or she waits.
But we can't wait. We were going to be married.
You learn to wait. The years pass.
But I don't want the years to pass without Tom. 5 years? That's almost a lifetime.
5 years, that's nothing.
Nothing? Well, maybe it's nothing to you, but... I know why you say that. All you're thinking of is 5 years of rent.
You little fool. I don't want your money. You don't belong here anyway. Why, every woman in this house puts you to shame. 5 years. My husband's in there for life. I wonder what you'll do if you're in Mrs. Slade's shoes.
Well, she's leaving in the morning.
Yes, she's leaving with her son in a coffin. He goes to chair at midnight. You can stay for the night, but please be out of here tomorrow morning.
A little more sacrifice of leaving. Can't take it, huh? I didn't think you could. That's the supper bell. Or maybe you're a little too good to eat with us.
Sound of the gong, the time will be exactly 11:30. Our program of recorded music continues.
The four brothers escaped in the storm. We arranged them just like this.
Blackboard gas and electric. Come to check the meters.
At this time of night? What do you think they're kidding, Mr. Peters? Hey, Countess, here's your boyfriend.
Well, would you look at Miss Miami, all done up to make with the eyes.
Where'd you rent those glasses, sugar?
Good evening, Mr. Peters. Mr. Peters is teaching me all about electricity. I'll show you downstairs. They're modest, isn't she?
Give me this rain any day to what it was like in the desert last year. Pete was doing a stretch at Yuma.
You and Pete certainly get around, don't you?
7 clinks in 11 years.
Regular crook's tour of America.
Well, Elsie the horse.
Drunk again.
Wow, am I wet.
Yeah, outside and inside both. Where's old Lady Barton?
Upstairs.
Where have you been? As if I didn't know.
Who's giving you a drink?
A 5-year stretch named Nancy. Only she's beating her bond in the morning.
One night stand, huh?
Can I get you something, Mrs. Slade? That's going to be a very pretty sweater. Don't know why I'm finishing it.
Mr. Peters, honey, you're just ruining my lipstick.
Well, now that I'm here, I might as well read the meter.
Oh, Gwen, did you tell your husband about us?
Well, no.
Now, look here, Gwen.
Oh, don't scold me, honey.
Well, I can't stand hanging around like this. You've got to tell your husband about us. Make him give you a divorce.
But, Mr. Peters, honey, you know you haven't enough money saved up. Have you?
No.
Do you think it's easy for me? Working like a slave in that awful bluebird laundry? Well,
quit your job. I don't want you working.
But, Mr. Peters, honey, I have to eat and have some place to sleep. $17, $18 a week's very little to you, but...
$17, $18 a week?
That's all.
Well, call a bluebird in the morning and tell him you're quitting your job. Don't you worry about the $17.
Oh, Mr. Peters, honey.
5 years, but it seems so long now, doesn't it?
Maybe, Elsie, you'd have your best years together, like Joseph and I would have had.
What do you mean?
He was afraid I couldn't wait for him. He tried to break out. I gave him life.
I'd like to stay, Mrs. Barton. And I'd like to have that smaller room next to yours, the $10 one.
Good morning.
I didn't realize you were the Michael Malone who won the Stanley case.
You don't really remember that case. That was before you were born.
I know. But other people remembered it. I had a civics teacher in college who did.
He used to quote passages from your speech to the jury.
Oh, it was a wonderful cause you fought for.
Yes, I guess it was. The odds were 100-1 for a conviction. I remember waiting for the verdict. It took 36 hours. It was like a wake. Foreman of a jury with a frozen-faced undertaker. And when he said not guilty, it was as if a dam burst. Young Stanley wept. His wife wept. I'm afraid I did, too. They gave me that desk set. Never did work, but I keep it around. It works in another kind of way. It reminds me.
I don't understand.
Why I'm here. As I told you before, that was a long time ago.
I'm lucky you're here. I'm glad you're taking Tom's case.
I'm not so sure it can now.
But you promised you would.
And I will. Yes, even if it means giving up another case.
Thank you.
Well, not at all, not at all. Sit down, Miss Johnson, and sit down. Tell me your story.
This is the prison town, Miss Johnson. I'm sure you will appreciate the fact that very few of our parents would be broad-minded enough to accept a convict's fiancée as a teacher for their children. I'm sorry.
Thanks. Everybody in this town is sorry.
Oh, hello.
Where can I find the boss?
That's him. Thank you.
What do you want?
A job.
Nothing doing.
Please, I want a job. I want to work here.
Are you kidding? Look, sister, you come back at about 5 and I'll take you to dinner maybe. But for a working dame, I like somebody with a little heft. And you'll last an hour.
Oh, Lord. Come on, please.
Will you get out of here?
Well, roll out the carpet. Getting kind of democratic, aren't we? What brings you here? I'm trying to get a job.
Are you still here? I told you nothing doing.
Oh, you big lug, give her a break.
Haven't I got anything to say about who works around here? I don't need another girl.
Sure you do. I told you this morning. Gwen's retiring.
Oh, yeah. Okay. I'll start you 15 a week. Give her Gwen's spot.
Oh, thank you.
Now get to work.
Hey, look who's here. Billy, thanks a lot.
You won't thank me when you see what a small crop of blisters a mango can raise. Well,
I can take it. I don't know why any of us take it. 8 hours a day, 6 days a week. Said that on the seventh day, as the good book says,
We can enter the pearly gates of Blackport Prison.
Take off your hat and coat. I'll get your uniform.
You're back here.
Aren't you glad to see me, Tom?
Well, look at me. Nancy, you can't afford to come running down here every week.
See, I didn't go home. I've been here all week.
What are you talking about? How about your job?
I work here now.
You mean you're teaching here in Blackport?
No, but I've got a job.
Doing what?
Working in the laundry.
In the laundry? Listen, Nancy.
Oh, please, Tom. I've hired a lawyer. We're going to take your case to Senator Miller.
I've had my belly full of the law. You're wasting your time.
Don't talk that way.
How do you want me to talk? Please, Your Honor, I saw a couple of Japs drop off the Hanseatic. Of course, I know the Hanseatic was sunk, but I'm not a liar. It's just a ghost ship, a flying Dutchman.
But you did see a ship called the Hanseatic, and some way we'll prove it.
How? By calling the ocean with a butterfly net?
But it's the truth, Tom, and you've got to fight for it.
I'll fight in my own way.
Well, I'll fight, too, in mine.
All right. Hang around here and be like these other women. Go ahead. Throw your life away. I can't stop you.
No, you can't.
Maybe I can at that. Go back home, Nancy. There's no use hanging around here, because if you come here next visit, I won't see you.
Dude. But it's been 2 weeks already, Judge Malloy. I was hoping I could bring him some news tomorrow.
You young people. Patience, patience, my dear. Perhaps next week.
Nancy, do me a favor, will you? If you're going over to see Tom, will you take this letter to George for me?
Well, of course, but why don't you go yourself?
Oh, I can't.
Why not?
Well, they won't ever let me see George. But George is going to get away soon. I've got his escape all figured out. You know what, Nancy? Maybe George would let Tom in on the plan, too.
Oh, no. No, Winnie. I'm going to get Tom a retrial.
Oh, well, you're not sober because I asked, are you?
I've got to hurry away. I'll be late.
Miss Barton?
You think I can have an answer?
What are you doing? Don't!
You couldn't take this to George.
Why not?
Because George doesn't exist except in Winnie's mind. He's been dead for years.
But Chester, honey, if you only told me where the money was hidden, I could be using it to get you out of this awful place.
It isn't the money, sweetheart. You know, I just went into the racket so I could get you things. Started with that mink coat. Only if you had all that money, I'm afraid I might lose you.
Chester!
Even that time on our honeymoon, no more than the dough was spent. You got feeling depressed. You was gone for 5 months.
But I came back, didn't I? And, honey pie, haven't I been right here working like a slave, ruining my health and my complexion, just waiting for you?
Sure, sweet, sure. I know you'll go through fire for me up to here.
But I don't see why we have to stay here when you're so rich. I could be spending all that money on you just to get you out of here.
Only maybe, after you got all through spending it, maybe I'd still be here, maybe. And maybe you'd get depressed again and you'd be gone and I wouldn't see you again for a year, maybe. Oh, you see what a spot I'm in, don't you, honey?
Oh, Chester.
All week I've been waiting, and then you don't tell me how you've been, or did you read a magazine or something? Hey, baby, don't tell me nothing no more.
Can I help it if I'm in the dumps? That Johnson kid gives me the creeping willies.
sit there like she's going nuts or something.
You want me to talk to you? You tell that guy of hers to give the kid a break and see her.
Okay, he'll see her. Uncle fix it. And he'll tell me how you banned him. Did you read a magazine or something? Talk to me like before. Maybe you call me ape again, huh?
Sure, gargantuan.
What's the matter with you? You a cripple or something? You talk to your girlfriend next time she comes.
Why don't you keep your nose out of my business, Monk?
I don't know. All I know is that Billy says he's got the call and willies from Nancy. Look, Tom, you're a nice guy. I like you like a brother. If you don't talk to your girlfriend next time, I'm going to bust your face. Right in the kisser.
You love Billy and you want to do what's good for her, don't you?
That's
it. Well, I love Nancy and I want to do what's right for her. She doesn't belong in this town, and she doesn't belong in any crummy laundry.
You know what I think? I think it's good for her. It'll toughen her up, give her plenty of muscle. I like a dame with a hefty wallop.
I like her the way she is. I want her to stay the way she is.
All I know is that if you don't talk to Nancy, Billy will kill me. And if Billy kills me, I'll kill you.
They're coming now.
Oh, Mr. Peters, honey, how lovely. But you should have spent all that money just on flowers for little me.
They cost 30 cents a bunch, but they're worth it.
I know, honey, but I need a pair of stockings so bad.
So bad's the only way you'll get them.
You all just don't understand. Does she, Mr. Peters? I'm sure you'll pardon us. Mr. Peters and I are going to an electrical exhibition.
What are you doing, 100 Watt? Teaching her how to rig a hot seat for Chester?
Oh.
You see, that's what I mean. I don't want you living in a place like this.
But, Mr. Peters, honey, aren't you forgetting?
What?
We haven't got the money yet, have we?
No, but I'll get it.
Oh, Mr. Peters, honey.
I'll do everything I can. Of course, I can't make him see you.
I know, Father, but... Well, it's just that he's been acting that way for weeks, and... I want him to know that there's hope for him. Please make him believe that.
I'll have a talk with him. Come, Adam. Come with me.
What's the charge, Father?
I guess it's called desertion. I'm talking about Nancy.
Forget it.
All right, come.
Don't get me wrong, Father. I know what she's going through. Suppose if you can't get me to go out there and see her, you want to take her a message. All right. Tell her I don't care if she hangs around here the rest of her life. I won't see her. I don't care what she does. She's wasting her time.
Tom, I don't think that girl's ever going to quit.
She'll quit when she realizes I'm not the starry-eyed Navy boy she fell for. She's not in love with me anymore. She's just a kid all choked up with pretty ideals. She'd hate a guy that figures if he hadn't been sap enough to try to help his country, he wouldn't be in here.
Sam, you'll be going out of here in a few years a free man. You want to go out into a country that's free, too.
What do you mean?
This morning, 2 hours ago, Japanese planes attacked us. Without warning, they bombed and killed our soldiers, sailors, and civilians. Right now, all over this country, 130 million people are getting ready to fight. Not only the Japs, but all men whose hate would destroy our country. Your country, too. They would be fighting for your chance to come out into a free world.
I was ready to fight for that, too. I still am. How can I?
The important thing is that you won't.
No.
The important thing is that I get a chance to. Look, Father, there must be other men out there. Hundreds of men who want to track those guys. Maybe if I talk to them, get up a petition, maybe they'll let us fight, parole us.
Go ahead, Tom. Talk to the men. Get up your petition. Go on, try it. You still want me to get back to that message?
No, Father. Not now.
You think it'll be all right?
Why doesn't he show up?
Take it easy, baby. Pretty soon he changes his clothes, huh?
Just give me a crack at them Japs, I'll mangle them.
Madam?
Yes?
Here's the answer to your petition.
Well, give up, baby, what's it say?
In response to the petition of the Blackport prisoners, they be paroled into the armed service of our nation. It's our considered opinion that...
Go on, Tom.
Here. Read the rest of this bill yourself.
Please remind these convicts that to fight our nation's enemies is a privilege restricted to free men. Signed, John P. Malloy, Chairman, Parole Board.
But you don't understand, Warden. I offered to go in the suicide squad.
Listen, the army needs us. We know this racket. It's our meat. Warden, you gotta make them understand.
They're afraid we'll take a powder.
Yeah, I was gonna take a powder. A keg of powder right down here at Hito's smokestack. Sorry, boys, but it's not up to me.
Let's go, guys. We've been suckers again, that's all.
Wait a minute, Adam. The rest of you boys, too. I want you to know that I respect and admire your patriotism. It's the law.
Your country's law. I'd like you men to go out of here feeling that.
Not a chance. See, we're Americans, all right. Just like the man who wrote that letter. Only he's out there and we're in here. All right, let him do the fighting. Call it his America. Okay. But don't come sniveling to us anymore with preaching flags.
Tom, what happened in there?
What do you suppose? They turned us down. We're not good enough for them.
Say that. I'll get you out of here soon.
I'll get out in my own way and in my own time.
You used to love me, don't you now?
No. No, I don't. Is that clear?
You're just upset because it didn't happen in there, don't you?
Get out of here and don't come back because I'm killing you, see?
Sit down.
Tom!
Madam, you see by my card, if I can be of service to you...
I've got to talk to you, Judge, right away.
Well, I'm busy right now. Why don't you call at my office tomorrow morning?
I want to talk to you right now. Excuse me. This won't come into solitary. The parole board meets tomorrow, doesn't it?
Yes, it does. At 4 is a rule.
Tom's case is in there tomorrow.
His case isn't on the calendar.
Well, I won't take no for an answer.
Oh, my dear Miss Johnson, leave the matter.
I'm sick of you stalling your depositions and your hocus pocus. And don't call me my dear Miss Johnson. The meeting's at 4. I'll be at your office at 5. You've been calling me crazy for 7 years. Because you're afraid. Because I've got a plan.
Winnie, forget it.
I've got it all worked out. I even got blueprints of the prison. I've got a plan that'll work. Winnie.
All right, but forget it.
Well,
I didn't let her in on it. Go on. What is it? Tell it. Well, listen. Every Friday night, the freight boat comes to the jute mill.
Yeah.
Well, those jute barrels are big. They're bigger than a man. Well, our men could haul them out and get into them. And then they're lowered into the boat. And then when the boat's out on the river, well, don't you see?
Gee, it might work. That ain't so crazy. That plan's a killer dealer, kid.
Huh, Billy?
Yeah, it might work at that.
They need somebody to run the boat.
Oh, but that's where Tom comes in. He used to make a living driving a boat.
Tom Adams won't be part of any prison break. So don't count on him.
You and Tom haven't been doing much talking lately. Maybe he'll feel differently about it after a few months in solitary.
Maybe. Maybe tomorrow he'll be out on parole.
Parole? Who's been giving you a high pole? Listen to a girl's parole.
Judge Malloy's before the board right now. He's putting Tom's case up to his brother.
Judge Malloy is what?
Dearie, you've been took in spades.
Why, he isn't even on speaking terms with his brother. He's a phony.
That's not true. He's a great lawyer. He's won great cases. You're just saying that about him because you want Tom in on the break.
Poor sap. You've been tough the way you dough.
I don't want to hear any more. All I know is that he's at the parole board right now pleading Tom's case.
The only pleading he's doing is for a quick one on the cuff at Herlihan's bar. Okay, kid. Tell me that plan again.
Well, every Friday night, the freight boat comes through the jute mill. Just me.
Oh, Miss Johnson, I was just about to call you. Senator Malloy had to postpone the board meeting. The war situation. You see, he said...
Yes, I see. You are fake. Everything I've heard about you must be true.
Well, my dear child, you've been put up to this by evil intriguers. People who are jealous of the fact that the senator has promised a decision in your case. This very evening.
How can you be so cheap? How can you lie like that?
Miss Johnson, I'll remind you, you're making bold accusations, and in front of my friends, too.
All right, then. Prove I'm wrong. Call the senator right now. I want to know his answer.
All right. All right. I'm sure he... I'll prove to you once and for all... Embarrass me in front of my friend. I've got only bills. Who's got a nickel? Hello? This is Judge Malloy. Yes. Is Senator there? Thank you. This ought to teach you a lesson, young lady, not to listen to idle and malicious gossip. Hello. Hello, John. Sorry to bother you again. No, nothing much. Just the Tom Adams case. You remember the one we were talking about today. Yes, that's the one. Where is John's friend? Thanks a million. There you are. The senator is recommending a pardon. Dividend from the phone company.
You ought to be over there behind the wall where Tom is.
My dear young lady, our relationship has reached that delicate stage where there is no further point in lying. The truth is, you have no case. You never have had a case. I've misled you, I'm sorry. I'd like to be able to pay you back sometime.
Getting out of solitary tomorrow.
No.
And the next day's visiting day. Think Winnie's plan will work?
It's got to work.
We'll spring him Friday night. Friday night.
What are you doing Friday night?
That ain't no kind of talk, baby.
I'm talking big stuff, Monk. Now listen. What do you do Friday night?
What do you think? The same old thing. Friday night we eat fish. Friday night we gotta work.
What kind of work?
We load the boat. We load the jute bales on the boat.
They're beautiful jute bales, darling. They're bigger than man.
I get it. Yeah, I get it.
Get a shave, too. You need one.
Yes, darling. I just gotta have money. Well, you can't expect me to arrange a getaway on $17 a week.
I thought you got 18.
What I mean is, things cost money. You just gotta tell me where you had the money, sweetheart. You just got to, so we can be together again.
It's a honey of a plan, Elsie. If anything goes wrong, I can take care of myself, all right. I got a knife, see?
Remember, the plan's no good unless you get Tom to run the boat.
I'll get him. He'll break his face, but I'll get him, all right.
I see Nancy today, Tom. Over the visit now, she was just sitting there looking. Not talking.
No, for me, she don't have to talk. You got some baby that time.
How'd you like to see the baby, huh? Bust out of here Friday night?
Oh.
You're going, true love.
Well, I was just taking something to the cleaner.
Sure, Chester. Can you imagine that poor sucker falling for a dame like that? Walking out on him when he's risking his neck just on account of you.
If you'll please let me pass.
Well, of course, sugar. Let her pass, girl. Here's a pass for Pete.
Oh! And this is for George!
What's going on?
Oh, nothing. Gwen just went south. For good.
I feel kind of skunky not telling about the break. And have it give us away? Little Miss Innocent still believes in parole and pardons. Maybe Gwen forgot a sugar rationing book.
Where's Gwen?
Why, Mr. Peters, honey.
Wait, Gwen, it's a matter of life and death.
She's thrown the switch on you. She's gone.
Oh, now, look, this is no time for kidding. Where's Gwen? She's got to be here. I got the company's money all mixed up. And the auditors are checking up sooner than I expected them to, and she was just holding the money. $300. Well, a trousseau.
Hot shot, you're a walking corpse. Your bride's parlaying your $300 into Chester's $60,000.
Oh.
There she is, girls. Just 8 more hours and she'll be pulling away from the dock with a load of our guys. My stomach feels like a bunch of mangoes. I eat too much. One good thing, after tonight, no more laundry. Maybe my guy will do all right for himself when we send out the wash.
It's going to be swell for Mrs. Barton, too.
You mean her husband's in it?
Sure. Monk felt sorry for the old man and let him in on it.
Well, back to the clink, girl. Fraser?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Come on, Nancy. News can wait. The dirty clothes go on forever.
I have to ask you to come with me.
Something's happened to Joseph.
In the back. Get back. I don't want your sympathy. Joseph's in a stab in the prison wall for trying to stop you, crazy break.
The rat. No wonder they knifed him. He was trying to save them, and they killed him. And even then, when he was dying, even then he wanted to help them. He asked me to go to the warden.
Did you?
What did you tell him?
I told him nothing. You know why? Because I want that break to happen. Because I know it'll fail.
Billy, look at them.
I'm talking to you too. Joseph's so innocent. You're the worst of them all. You and your innocence. Pretending you wouldn't mix in a break.
What break?
Take it easy, kid. And when it's all over, don't any of you come crying to me because I'm through with you. With all the sympathy and help and love I was really much to waste on you.
What break?
At 9 o'clock. We were going to tell you later. He's in it all right.
Stop. Now take it easy, kid.
Well, let me go.
You go to the warden. Get out of my way. Don't be a fool. They'll get Tom extra time just for planning this break.
And our guys, too. You sing to the warden, and Tom will wake up with a knife in his back.
Mrs. Barton! Get out of here! Help me! Is somebody getting a doctor?
Why don't
you call the warden if you want to stop it?
No.
Why come to me?
Because if you only tip the case to your brother, we can still save Tom.
Oh, you haven't got a case.
Read that and tell me we haven't got one. Read it.
Mexico nears war. Good, more the merrier.
Oh, no, this SS Hanseatic sunk.
Another one, huh? Fish won't have elbow room to swim anymore.
Judge Malloy, don't you remember? The SS Hanseatic is the boat that Tom saw.
Prove there wasn't anything. There was a Hanseatic?
We sunk last night by a Mexican gunboat.
Lady, you have got a case. A whale of a case.
Then plead it with your brother.
He wouldn't listen.
Make him listen.
He won't even see me.
Make him see you. I'll go with you.
Oh, I don't know. I think it's too late. I don't think it's in me.
Judge, it's your kind of a case. You've got a cause now, the kind of a cause that made you great once. It made you a great fighter.
Booze fighter, liar, faith, everything you said I was.
You will be a liar, Miss Faith, if you turn me down now. You'll be finishing an innocent man by letting him break the law for the first time.
I've fought for the underdog in my time. I won all the lost causes. My own.
Go out and win it back. You won't only be fighting for Tom Adams, you'll be fighting for yourself.
Can't face the risk of losing.
I'm sorry, Mrs.
And so am I.
Mr. Malloy.
Gentlemen, your last consideration boils down to this. It's serious, but not grave. The question is, what does this senatorial committee bring back to Washington? Tompkins, I told you
that I was never to be admitted. Well, he didn't admit me. I pushed my way in.
You'll save yourself and me a lot of embarrassment if you'll turn right around and walk out.
But he came here for my sake.
I'm here for my own sake.
Please, Mr. Malloy, there's trouble at the prison. You're the only man who can stop it.
What kind of trouble?
A break. It's 9 o'clock.
Give me the facts and the men involved, and I'll phone the warden.
Oh, no, no.
Her young man, Tom Adams, is in it. He's the key man in the break. I came here to talk for him.
What there to talk about? He'll have to take his medicine like the others.
Listen, John, I haven't tried a case in years. But I've got a case to plead now. A case that he would want me to plead. Hear me out. Then if you want to call the warden to ruin more years of Tom Adams' life, you still have time.
We've got some pretty important work to do here, Malloy.
I don't care how important it is. A man's life is at stake.
Well, we're concerned with the safety of 130 million lives. We're at war, Michael. Or hadn't you come out of your saloon long enough to find that out?
Yes, I've come out of my saloon long enough to find out a lot of things. You know what we're fighting for?
Michael!
I repeat, do you know what we're fighting for? I know why I am. For the right to my bottle, to sit around in a corner saloon. Yes, I stand up like you on the 4th of July and sing, Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner still wave? Wave or what? Over my booze. That's why I sing, but I'm only a drunken sot, a disgrace to my country. Over what does it wave for you?
Just what do you want, Michael?
The thing we're fighting for on the seven seas and five continents.
the thing we're overlooking here at home. Justice.
What's that got to do with a break?
Get to your point. Tom Adams was jailed 6 months ago. He was convicted on the strength of a non-existing boat, the SS Hanseatic. This phantom boat, this figment of the imagination, has now become tangible, gentlemen.
The French monk, twin diesels, a kid could run it.
Good, baby, good.
Not that one, Chester.
Not that one. Oh. Oh.
If this story is true, you have grounds for an appeal.
Fine, and days, weeks, months will go by. Let's think in minutes. Now, 8:45. At 9, Tom Adams will make that break.
All I need to do is to phone the warden and he'll stop it.
By implicating Adams. By making him commit his first crime in the noble name of legal procedure.
You're asking me to cover up a crime.
The real crime is that Tom Adams was sent to jail in the first place. And if you let him make this break, you'll be as responsible as he is.
You don't know what you're saying, Michael.
As bad as Chester.
Oh, I'm all right.
Monk.
What?
Did he know about Joe Barton?
No.
Listen, Monk, I had to do it, see? I had to knife the old guy. He'd have tossed.
Shut up.
Free Tom Adams, John. Now, this minute. Let him know the singing glory of the just word freely given. Let him walk once more among his fellows, a free man in a free land. Long before that black day of December 7th, that boy sensed his country's peril. He was ready to leave his job and his girl. And she was ready to let him go because she knew that was the way it had to be. Well, he never went. An innocent man, he was shut away. On the day the enemy struck, he volunteered again. The answer was no. Twice denied. Don't deny him again.
I don't know. If I only had time.
Time, time, time! 10 years ago, when Hirohito marched into Manchuria, we could have knocked his big teeth down his throat with a backhand slap. But China was far away. We had time. 6 years ago, when Hitler marched into the Rhineland, we could have put him in a lunatic asylum. But the Rhineland was far away, too. Again, we had time. I know what you're thinking, that these are big things, and Tom Adams is small. Only one ordinary American. But he's part of this country, and a part of you. And if he dies, part of America dies with him. Before 9 o'clock, he must decide if he's worth fighting for.
Out of here to put the finger on me.
do now? I don't know about you, but I'm getting out of here. For good.
Tom, you're free. You're going to be free.
Still the best lawyer in the house of Mallory.
Thank you, Sandy. Now, how's about a little drink on the house?
What do you want, dearie? What do I say about a room? I'm sorry, dearie, there ain't no room. We're all moving. There ain't no one left to handle the house.
Billy! When they showed us in the summer our room? I thought you went.
Well, I'm back. Somebody's got to keep you dames from going off the deep end. Go on. Show my room. I'm taking Mrs. Barton.
If I'm digging in for the duration, I might as well do it in style.
Don't be frightened. Everything will be all right. I've been here for 7.5 years waiting for George. So you see, I know all the ropes. I can help you. I want us to be friends.